5. Microbes in Human Welfare. The branch of biology which deals with the study of microbes is called microbiology. Microbes in household production. Idli, dhokla, jalebi are common Indian delicacies. It involves fermentation. A number of microbes are involved in their production through the process of fermentation. First, microbes in food preparation. The dough for dhokla is prepared by mixing gram flour, that is besan, with buttermilk. The lactobacilli bring about the fermentation process. Many species of bacteria and yeast are useful in making idli and dosa. The bubbles of carbon dioxide trapped in gluten make idlis puffy. The microorganisms like species of bacillus, candida and saccharomyces are involved in this process. Many lactobacilli are involved in the preparation of jalebi and naan. Then, microbes as the source of food. Some microbes or their fruiting bodies are directly used as a source of food rich in protein. The term SCP or single cell protein denotes dead and dried cells of microbes like bacteria, algae, molds and yeast. Mushrooms and truffles are directly used as food. They belong to basidiomycetes, that is fungi, and produce large fleshy fruiting bodies which are edible. They are low calorie, sugar free, fat free, but rich in protein, vitamin, mineral and amino acids. Some mushrooms are non-edible, that is poisonous, for example toadstools. Then microbes in industrial production. First, production of alcoholic beverages. Alcoholic beverages are the products of alcoholic fermentation of specific substrates. They include liquors like wine, beer and whiskey. A number of strains of the yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, var ellipsoides, are used in industrial production of wine. Different flavors of wine are obtained by using different fruit juices. Beer is another alcoholic liquor obtained from fermented grains, mostly barley. Suitable strains of S. cerevisiae are used for fermentation. Whiskey is obtained by fermenting mixed grains of corn, wheat, barley, etc. The product of fermentation is then distilled. B. Organic acid fermentation. A number of organic acids are obtained by fermentation using various microbes. For example, citric acid is obtained by Aspergillus niger. Gluconic acid is obtained from Aspergillus niger. Fumaric acid is obtained from Rhizopus arisus. Acetic acid, that is vinegar, is obtained by Acetobacter acetae. Then, vitamin production. The vitamins are manufactured by fermentation technology using different microbial sources. The examples, vitamin B2 is obtained from Neurospora gossypii and Erythrocium ashbii. Vitamin B12 obtained from Pseudomonas denitrificans, and vitamin C is obtained from Aspergillus niger. Then antibiotic production. Antibiotics are the substances produced in small amounts by certain microbes to inhibit the growth of other microbes. They may be antifungal or antibacterial. Examples: chloromycetin obtained from Streptomyces venezuelae. Erythromycin is obtained from Streptomyces erythreus. Penicillin is obtained from Penicillium chrysogenum. Streptomycin is obtained from Streptomyces griseus. Then gibberellin production. Gibberellins are a group of growth hormones mainly produced by higher plants and fungi to promote growth by stem elongation. They are used in breaking, dormancy, and inducing flowering also. Then enzyme production. The enzymes are biocatalysts which either initiate or accelerate all biochemical processes in living organisms. These are the examples of enzymes used in industrial food processing. So these are the names of the enzyme and these are microbial source. Invertase, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Pectinase, Sclerotina libretin. Lipase, Rhizopus spp. Cellulase, Trichoderma conigae. Then dairy industry. Various products are obtained from milk in dairy industry, such as cheese, yogurt, buttermilk, paneer. Species of Streptomyces, Penicillium and Lactobacillus are commonly employed. Curd and buttermilk were produced using lactic acid bacteria. Cheese too is a product of fermentation by fungi. Now microbes in sewage treatment. Large quantity of wastewater are generated, which is called as sewage. It is essential to remove organic matter from the wastewater before it is made available for human use. It must be treated in sewage treatment plants, that is STPs. The sewage treatment includes three basic processes: primary treatment, secondary and tertiary treatment. The primary treatment. It is a physical process and removes large pieces of floating debris, oily substances, etc. through filtration and sedimentation. The secondary treatment is a biochemical process. The primary effluent is passed into the large aeration tanks. It is constantly agitated mechanically and air is pumped into it. Due to this, vigorous growth of useful aerobic microbes into flocks takes place. These microbes consume the major part of the organic matter in the effluent as they grow. Due to this, BOD, that is biological oxygen demand of the effluent, is significantly reduced. Then, tertiary treatment. Once the BOD of wastewater is reduced, it is passed into a settling tank. Here the bacterial flocks are allowed to sediment. The sediment is called activated sludge. Small part of this is passed back into aeration tank and the major part is pumped into large tanks called anaerobic sludge digesters. Here, anaerobic bacteria grow and digest the bacteria and fungi in the sludge. During this, digestion gases such as methane, hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide are produced that form gases. Effluents from these plants are released in natural water bodies like rivers and streams. Then, microbes in biogas production. Biogas, which mainly contains methane, is used both as a domestic as well as industrial fuel. Its production involves three major processes: anaerobic digestion or hydrolysis, 2. Acetogenesis or acidogenesis, 3. Methanogenesis. The anaerobic digestion occurs by certain anaerobic bacteria like species of Clostridium, and in this process, complex insoluble polymers are converted to simple soluble monomers. These monomers are further converted into organic acids, chiefly acetic acid, by enzymes of acidogenic bacteria. Finally, acetic acid is transformed to biogas by the enzymes of methanogenic bacteria. These bacteria include species of Methanococcus and Methanobacillus. So we can conclude polymers to monomers by anaerobic bacteria, monomers to organic acids by acetogenic bacteria, and organic acids to methane, carbon dioxide and other gases by methanogenic bacteria. Now the advantages of biogas. It is cheap, safe, renewable source of energy. It is used for domestic lighting, cooking, street lighting, as well as small-scale industries. It burns with blue flame without smoke. It helps to improve sanitation of the surrounding. It is eco-friendly and does not cause pollution. It can be easily stored and transported. Then microbes as biocontrol agents. The biological agents, that is organisms, which can be used to kill or check the proliferation of disease-causing agents are biopesticides. Use of microorganisms or biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests is called biocontrol. Four groups of biocontrol agents are known. They are bacteria, fungi, protozoans, and viruses. So, these are microbial pesticides and their host range. In bacteria, Bacillus thuringiensis, BT, the host range is caterpillars, larva of aedes, black flies, some adult beetles, wax moth. Then the fungi, Puvaria bassiana, the host range, aphids, mealybugs, mites. Then protozoans, Nosema locusti, the host range, grasshoppers, caterpillars, some corn borers. Viruses, nucleopolyhedrovirus or NPV, and the host range is gripsy moths and caterpillars. Now these are microbial herbicides or bedicides. The pathogenic fungi as myco herbicides are Phytophthora palmivora, Alternaria crassa, Fusarium sp. And the bacterial pathogens as herbicides are Pseudomonas sp, Xanthomonas sp, Agrobacterium sp. Now, microbes as biofertilizers. For better and sustainable agricultural production, the use of renewable nutritional sources, biofertilizers, is necessary. It is essential to switch over to organic farming. Bacterial biofertilizers. Rhizobia are the nitrogen-fixing bacteria that form symbiotic association with roots of leguminous plants. They bring about nodule formation on the roots and multiply inside the nodule. They fix atmospheric nitrogen into organic forms which can be used by plants as nutrients. Free-living nitrogen-fixing bacteria such as Azotobacter and Azospirillum are also used as biofertilizer. Then cyanobacterial biofertilizers. Cyanobacteria are autotrophic microbes that are widely distributed in aquatic and terrestrial environment. Some species of Anabina are symbiotic, that is Anabina azolae. Azolla is an aquatic fern. It propagates vegetatively and spreads in rice fields very rapidly. Anabina azolae and nostoc are commonly used as biofertilizer for rice. Then fungal biofertilizers, mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is a fungus. It forms symbiotic association with the roots of higher plants. There are two types, ectomycorrhiza and endomycorrhiza. The ectomycorrhiza increase surface area of roots and accelerates water and nutrient uptake. The endomycorrhiza grow in between and within the cortical cells of roots. Now, in our country, many biofertilizers are available in market.